This time to start. Okay.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, Konnichiwa. Let's start today's program. Okay. So the today's program is about the humanoid. So today and the next week we will discuss about the humanoid. Okay. So the most important subject is this maybe. Hi, humanoid. It's today's subject. Okay. Today's main subject is why humanoid is necessary, or why humanoid, or what humanoid will do, or something. Yes? Robot shape. Robot assistant in here. Assistant. Or robot assistant, robot companion in here. Robot assistant, robot companion, or some other robot? Yes. There are someone wants to develop some robot, useful robot. One approach is maybe the some like animal like Nanka. Animal-like shaped robot, or some living creatures like robot. Yes, but something is about the completely new shape. Yes. どんなロボット？どんなロボットかな？ニューシェイプ。まあいいや。はい。はい。Someone like animal like robot。はい。Some researcher developed animal like robot。Yes, learn from animal functions, of course. Yes, and
maybe some people need such as pets, lovers, like cat lover or something.
Get to help you,
sir. Get lovers.
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 Lovers. What's the
meaning?
Cute. Yeah. Maybe. We know many animals. So from the outward appearance or shape or outward appearance, we can estimate outward appearance. We can estimate its function. Yes, this is one important point. Estimate its ability or functions, because this animal is very commonly we watch, we look, and also so therefore some kind of familiarity or some kind of affinity we feel some sympathy or something. So the yes, functional factor and also emotional factor, they are both sides. Maybe if we follow the animal shape or some previously existing type something following robot, it's like this, maybe. So I don't know which kind of animal you picked up. Yes, for example, snake. Maybe you may have some snake functions. So that you can estimate, yes, this robot will do something. Or maybe some turtle-like robot like this. Maybe some function will estimate. Yes, maybe this kind of turtle-like robot is main work will be the swimming. Maybe. Not not dog, walking on the ground.
Yes.
So the, we know about that. Yes, like cheetah-like robot has run fastly. Yes, cheetah-like robot, it can run fastly. Or lion-like robot, it is dangerous for human, maybe. So the, from its outward appearance, we can estimate its function, and we feel some kind of first impression based on our common sense or previous knowledge, maybe. Yes, and also some kind of familiarity. Yes, cat-like robot, dog-like robot, it makes some feeling, cuteness or something. Yes, okay. And then today's topic is about the human robot, human-shaped robot. Yes, today's main subject is why we need humanoids and what kind of task we estimate for the humanoid robot. Or a humanoid robot is necessary or not? So this is what I ask you to consider today. Okay. Yes, it is categorized into three types: semi-humanoid robot, small size humanoid robot, and full-size robot. Full-size humanoid robot. Yes, firstly, the definition of humanoid robot is here. From Wikipedia, it says the humanoid is something that has an appearance resembling a human being. Yes, morphologically similar to the human skeleton. And then anything with uniquely human characteristic and adaptation. Yes, human robot is a robot that based on the general structure of human. Yes, some robot is the two legs and upper torso. That is a semi-human robot because the mobility is not only two legs, but some robot has two arms, two legs and a head. This is completely human robot, maybe. And the similar word, android. What is android? Android is a male and genoid. Gymnoid or genoid is a female. Is a human robot designed to look like such as a real person. So the android has the robot is synthetic organism, like the look, outward appearance, and this operation, this attitude is like a human being. Yes, it's an android. The semi-humanoid robot is a upper body is like a human being, but the lower part is using the wheel or caterpillar, crawlers or something. Any movement way is okay. Yes, so therefore, this is Fujitsu's robot, Mitsubishi Heavy Industries robot, Wakamaru. And that is Emu. This is a hybrid type, two legs, but wheels here. So the hybrid type. For the rapid, faster movement, these wheels are used. And the plain surface, the wheel is convenient, but uneven condition or climbing the stairs or somewhere, that these two legs is useful to move. So that this kind of hybrid type is also there. Yes, this is also some kind of hybrid type to four legs, using the four legs to stability of this robot, but mainly using these four points to move. This is DLR. DLR is a German space engineering, space research center, space laboratory. It's developing some kind of human robot. It is maybe the final target is it will be used as a robot astronaut, maybe.
Yes, I will show this movie, for example. Move over the room.
German researchers hope that their coffee-making ball-catching robot named Justin will become man's new best friend. Justin is being developed for use in space or in the home. But who would want to scratch their pet robot behind the ears?
Ball-catching robot.
He may not be able to walk or talk, but he can catch a ball, make a cup of coffee, and dance. His name is Justin, and he's a life-sized robot. German scientists hope robots like Justin will one day become an indispensable addition to the home. Justin has a head, two arms and fingers and boots on rollers. It has two cameras for eyes and is being developed by a group of researchers and scientists at the German Aerospace Center in the southern town of Oberpfaffenhofen. Sensors are built in across the robot's body, which along with his eyes and an ability to sense his surroundings in three dimensions, allow him to carry out commands such as catching a ball.
What is special about Justin compared to the most other humanoids is that he has all over its body sensors, which makes it possible for him to feel, touch, and give feedback to contact with the environment. For example, the fingers can have contact with the objects, and this allows it for Justin to find manipulation tasks.
Justin's arms are lightweight and are able to move smoothly via ball joints at the shoulders, elbows, and wrists. Similar technology is being used aboard the International Space Station. Bernie and his team think that a self-thinking humanoid like Justin could allow for humans and robots to work much more closely together, especially in the home.
So we have Robin Justin is especially suited for his service robotics, so in the future we think of that everyone has a robot at home to help, especially elderly people can be helped by a system like this to reach cups on a higher cupboard, for example. So the robot has to be quite autonomous to behave in a sensible way.
Yes. They developed this kind of lightweight, flexible robot. So this robot, these two arms are used to this testing. Okay. Next robot is this is Spanish company. I will show this Spanish company's corporate video. So this is a recent one, and you can find the inside of this robot on this corporate video.
Deep in the heart of the city of Barcelona, one of the most beautiful and modern cities in the world, there's a group of passionate engineers devoted to a single goal, to make our life easier. We are Autorobotics. Nowadays, technology is helping us with our daily lives. But we think it can still be improved in so many ways. That's why we want to go one step forward. By using robotics, we firmly believe that robots can assist humans in ways we can't even imagine. Robotics has an inconceivable potential, and we are convinced that it will improve our lives like we've never dreamt before. Imagine a world where you can transform repetitive and annoying tasks to something practical, fast, and even enjoyable or engaging. This is the future we want to build. But there's still a long way to get there. This is just the first step. Our robotics. We have spent more than a decade focusing on humanoid robotics research. 2004, when we launched our first humanoid service robot, our products have been evolving continuously. Our service robots are being shipped worldwide and are used every day. Over the years, we've been accumulating a lot of experience in many fields, and that has pushed us to develop new robots for solving specific needs. Like inventory taking, for example, ambient assisted living, or like industry demand. You are invited to come with us to this new feature. We are building together. We are AgroPilot.
This is corporate advanced advertisement video, promotion video. Yes, they want to make some services in home. They said. But why humanoid robot? It remains this problem, this question. Okay? Yes, service in home, maybe. They want to provide some services. But why robot? Especially why humanoid robot? Yes, of course. Yes, that's a humanoid. If service is necessary, yes. You don't like human worker? You don't like human worker? I don't understand. Why human as a robot? Yes, which is better. And maybe the some shape, yes? This is mobile robot, or yes, in that video, also some mobile robot is there. As I said, robot to the, maybe I have said, robot to the important point, maybe, not only single task, but various kind of task. It can realize, it can be, it can achieve, maybe, not only carrying, but carrying the food, but also carrying some newspaper or something. Yes, not only one specific task, but it can be used to many kind of tasks. Is one important point. It is a different point from specific automatic machine. Maybe specific automatic machine, maybe doing some one single task repeatedly, but only that work. So the robot is more versatile, more various kind of task it can realize, it can carry out maybe. So, but also, you mean why human robot? Humanoid shape is the strongest one, we have to find some answer. Yes, okay. Yes, let's continue. Now, this is another type robot. This is Korean Future Robotics. Provide this kind of robot using this panel, touch screen to give some information and order to this robot. And also the facial expression is there. This is from 2010.
Yes, I will show some videos, most of the videos. Yes, sir.
I'll call it a
car.
Centers, malls, airports. hospitals, and it is used as a host to provide information and entertainment to the public. Futuro has a number of features. It is a very advanced robot with different facial expressions. It can interact with users, not only with the traditional touch screen, but also with a face and a speech. So thanks to text-to-speech, we can interact with users in many languages very easily, and that provides a way for users to get information not only from the traditional kiosk method, but also from the face that will interact with them and provide them information. Fuel also has a number of sensors, sonic sensors, laser sensors, which allow it to track visitors, follow them. Also, it can welcome visitors, so not only it can provide information, but also it will entice users into starting an interaction. This way, we can, for example, provide games, surveys, and instead of waiting for the visitor to come to the robot and come to the information, we can send the information to the visitors. Also, thanks to the back screen, we also have promotional space that can be used for video, for image, and very easily available by the user. Another very interesting feature is that we have a smart card reader, contact or contactless, that enables Futuro to be used in transaction services, for example restaurants, and we will even be able to print a receipt after the transaction is completed. So we have a standalone transaction method, which is very innovative.
Future Robotics Futuro is one service robot. Yes, AI or something, and also he explained several functions. Yes, many functions contained here, and it is it might be useful for various tasks, maybe. But why not human work? I have to ask. I have to ask them. Okay. Hi, John, next. Yes, similar is a paper. Maybe it's more popular for Japanese students or some persons, maybe. The paper also has some display here, touch display, touch screen here. And maybe it's okay. Two years ago it has launched. And it also used as some recipient. Yeah, it has been used for the advertisement or shop the recipient or something. Okay.
One, two, three, go! need to take one home. I'm ticklish today.
That will probably also be used a lot to entertain your guests, and we think that a lot of coffee applications will be very interesting.
Yes, so therefore the paper also has some workshop like hackathon to find the appropriate applications, how to use this paper, some idea is gathering, and this is now Priya is doing. Yes, this is a semi-humanized part, and this next is the small size part. Small size robot part is more, maybe more useful. Yes, small size robot is like the Sony's SDR or Curio, but it has already finished for development. Yeah, this is used for some research work of dynamic walking or some human-robot interaction or something. Next, finding some algorithm to find the balancing algorithm and also path planning algorithm, and then some standing up, then fold down. Yes, also the Fujitsu Kenkyu Sho, Fujitsu Automation Limited, is also developed this kind of small size robot for the robotics researchers. And this is a hobby robot. Yes, the Kondo Kanaku Corporation is very famous in Japan for the hobbyists. Yes, radio control system they have provided, but one of their products looks like this kind of hobby robot. Yes, assembled by themselves as a hobbyist. Yes, it looks like here. And then the develop this robot. The latest version may be KHR3H3 version 2. It runs last year. How much is it? これは、これ出てこないね。つまり、アドオンが出てくるだけだ。これだ。 123,000円です。 このパーツセットね。パーツセット。 Assembled by user itself. Of course. これ見ますか?ノーマルでも。 Here. Yes, various kind of walking mode can be realized by this robot. Pi, he can do various kind of walking mode. Balancing and also is okay. Jump. 12万3000円。Pi needs more prepare because mainly for the battle competition. Yeah? The hobbyist like this kind of battle competition and make some path change or something and doing this kind of robot is doing some remote operation. Okay, radio control, remote operation. So I show some small short video. This is short one. Hydraulic system actuator is used here, and rubber actuator is used here, and airbag type actuator is used here, and then the hydraulic actuator is here, and WL
85,000 pounds. This is about 45 years ago, and he realized the static walking. Static walking is the on the footprint, on the footprint, the gravity, center of gravity is on the footprint always, and then it works statically. And then the 90s, this laboratory is semi-dynamics movement right here, and in-plane walking dynamic movement is here, and in 1984, they realized this WL10 revised the dynamic walking, they have realized. Okay. Yes, about the late 80s, yes, about this period, I have there in this laboratory. But not doing the walking robot. My research topic is about the manipulator at that time. Yes, I will show this short video about the history of human robots here. You can find many pictures. Yes. And then, not recent, it is also 10 years ago, Furuta Takanishi, my senior student, he is now a professor at Nishi Wasuda, and developed this human robot 10 years ago. So I will show you this here. Honda developed this robot about 1990. The P1 is here, and P2, and Astimo is here. Okay. Before showing this, the late 70s, they have started the two-leg walking mechanisms. This 10th anniversary, 10 years anniversary video. So that these 10 years it will show.
Thank you.
10 years, okay? First 10 years video about the 6 years. And maybe if you want to know more about the Honda's robot development, you should watch this 15 minutes video. It shows the detail from the at the beginning of the development story, and some control scheme has been explained there. Okay. Hi. Next is the University of Tokyo's One Laboratories. Inoue-sensei's robot, the laboratory's robot is here, about also the 15 years ago. It has developed right here and right here. And then the Japan has some national project about the human robot. HRP means the human robot project. It has been done during 2000 years. Yes? Around 2000 years. Firstly, it used Honda's robot, but after that, it will mainly use based on the University of Tokyo's robot, and this is HRB2D and HRB2 and HRB3. Yes. So this is Japanese, but I will show this HRB robot. It says the research of human robot means the every work, every task human can do should be transferred to the robot. So they are how to transfer the all of the tasks that the human being can do is achieved by robot. So this is some kind of a research project about that.
どう作成せ歩行制御視覚に基づく移動技術視覚に基づく多指反応把握制御などの研究を進めています。HRB2は日本ゲームを出会う会津万代さんの踊りの動作や転倒しても 起き上がって作業を再開させる動作を世界に先駆けて実現しました。HRB2の進化系である HRB3は動きの自由度が増し、より複雑な作業への対応が可能となりました。屋外作業で必要な塵や埃の防御や
雨などに対する防水性能が追加された。ウォータープルーフとか建築現場で使用する滑りやすい路面である二足歩行も可能となりました。スリッピーフレイトグランドコンディション。人間型ロボット研究で開発された先端的なロボット技術は今後産業用、家庭用を問わず社会の様々な分野で利用されるようになるでしょう。
It will be used various places, various tasks, this video says. Yes. And then maybe you know that the DARPA's robot challenge, DARPA Grand Challenge is an autonomous vehicle, no unmanned vehicle, and DARPA Urban Challenge is Grand Challenge is autonomous vehicles challenge. On the desert area, and the DARPA Urban Challenge is autonomous vehicles urban city area, and then the third DARPA's challenge is robotics challenge. It is this kind of the disaster areas reconstruction or something. So therefore, the it gives some tasks. DARPA's robot challenge task is drive a utility vehicle at the site and travel dismounted across Lavrov and remove debris blocking entryway and open the door and enter the building and climb an industrial ladder and traverse an industrial walkway and use a tool to break through the concrete tunnel and locate and close the valve near the leaking pipe and connect the fire hose to the stand pipe and turn on the valve. It's a work. It must be done by robot. Okay. So this is a challenge. The task is there and the task is given and several robots has challenged. Yes, this is the 2013 June, the virtual robot challenge. And the trials is 2013 December. Yes, these robot has attended that. これ、ディボーキーは NASA。これはシャフトはジャパニーズロボットで。
I don't
remember. I don't remember. これはアメリカのロボットで、これは多分ジャーマニーズロボット。ジャーマニーズロボットですね。で、これで終わっちゃうのか。あ、これだ。で、例えばこれでしょ。ビーフに乗ってこうですよとか言って。で、ファイナルチャレンジ is these robots is can do that.And finally, yes, I will show this video on challenge final event compilation. 書いてあるから I will show this. The final result is first place is Korean's robot. Second place is the Pensacola って maybe United States で CM's robot is third place. They say this challenge is the challenge to promote the technological development, research and development. And then it will be used to, it also the preparation for some disasters, of course. So this kind of tough robot is necessary to protect something for the disasters. So they developing this kind of robot. So therefore, this has been done on the 2015. So and after that, also Japan has developing this kind of disaster robot. So these three robot has announced as last year's exhibition in Tokyo. Yes, December's exhibition. This is one and HRP's revised version, and also Hydra is a high-speed, high-torque, full motor driver. So using this ROS OS and then, and Jackson is here, and Hydra is a hydraulic motor is using, and hydraulic fuel cell is using. So I will show a small, short introduction video about this. Demonstration of human growth. It can carry heavy workload because they have developed some high torque actuators to realize this, especially for this water cooling mechanism also mounted on. Yes. Cooling is also important part for the high torque output. Not only deck, but also the four arms is using like this. Yes, this kind of mode to go through the. Yes, some obstacle is there, so the doing the this height is not enough for the standing pose. So it, at that case, they are using this kind of mode to move forward.
Narrow space, that is 10 more. 10 more.
one of them can find by itself. Which robot you are interested in? It's a nice car.
Sakura, Sakura.
multilingual verbal expression checked. Go ahead, take a few steps.
Thank you.
capture interface 3D.
More than anything for me, it was about being present in the space, listening, smelling the room, and so that I could, everything could be new in every moment. I think the challenge is just something inherent to the mocap. There's obviously a lot of imagination involved because there's no set to work with, and I didn't get to talk to a face when I was doing it, and you know, a million choreography things to remember. So I've done a lot of theater where there are technical things to remember, but this was a whole different ballgame. So this is a lot to remember while doing an emotionally intense scene. So it's challenging.
Okay. Cameras rolling.
Initializing and send you to a store in the soul.
Okay, recording. Defective model. Disassemble and check the required components.
So, I'll go back to the final part. Why? Humanoid robot. Yes? As I said, human walker and humanoid robot. What is the difference? Humanoid. Yes? What is the difference? Why we need humanoid? Yes, I ask you to think in today's subject. But one thing I have found out is human worker need education. Yes, need train, but no necessary human robot. Robot has preliminary program, and also they have some, yes, if it has some autonomous intelligence, artificial intelligence, they can understand everything, and then they can do it by itself. why we have more populations in the world but don't use human worker, and we want to, yes, someone wants to use the human in place of the human worker, because education cost is too expensive. I don't know exactly, but this is only the slight difference. Yes? Yes, this is one I'm thinking, one opinion. You have to think by yourself.